What are they going to do with the statue that's there? Do they have any plans?
It's what?
It's at the front entrance of Vans.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that.
Yeah, like at the right to the left of like the front door. It's the.
It was only at convention center for a little bit, right?
It was there for like a couple of weeks, yeah. I think.
Okay. Did they get permission to put it there, or did they just put it there?
No, they got permission to put it there.
Amazing.
It's, I mean, it's hugely flattering. I mean, for anyone to build a statue of you, right? Like, I've never actually spoken about this at all. Yeah. In fact, I've never walked up to the statue at all.
Did you know they were doing this?
I did, yeah. But later in the game, and I understood why, you know? Like, Vans and as a huge heart. Right, like it wanted really to elevate and show that skateboarding is important to it, you know, and that was the thinking. We'll make a statue of this guy because it was a pivotal moment, like for the brand and the time, and they wanted to make that for me as a celebration of 20 years, kind of without me knowing about it.
Yeah.
Oh. Right? Okay.
Now I'm the kind of guy that, like, when I was younger, if I like won a contest or I did well in a contest, the first kid I saw, I just gave him the trophy.
Okay.
I was that guy. Yeah. I was that guy that just went, get rid of it.
Yeah. Wow.
Things mean nothing, right? Like the artifacts like that. Like to me, I felt like it was the experience. And then, you know, if I won a contest and like that first kid walks up and he thinks you're going to high five him and just hand him the trophy and he's stoked.
Right? Oh, yeah.
Made his life.
Yeah. It's incredible.
And then that kid
he's still holding on to it.
Yeah.
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 So I was kind of like that guy. So when I first heard that they were going to make a statue, I was a little bit. Just being completely honest, this is totally transparent, sure. Right? Like, at first, I looked at it and went, I don't give a shit about that. I don't want anything like that at all. And then I thought about it and I went, fuck, like, when have we ever won a battle as a skateboarder with the general public? We're always supposedly trespassing. You know, skateboarding is not a crime,
right?
Kind of thing, right? Mm-hmm. Like, if you're a skateboarder, you're a downbeat, or you know, that kind of thing. And like when I skated that like Staples Center ledge, I timed the guy. It took 9 minutes, security guard. He'd go around and I got the trick. I thought like if they put the statue on the ledge permanently, just a statue of a skater on the ledge, right? And it's there permanently.
You like skate stop it.
We actually won a battle.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
like
totally.
With the general public, they went, you can't skate here, but we put a statue on the spot. So can we?
Right.
Yeah. That was, I thought that would be kind of epic.
Yeah.
That would be good.
On the ledge.
Right.
Yeah. On the ledge. Right. So I voiced that and said, put it on the ledge. It'll be sick. You know, put a plaque at the bottom that says, this is the one and only time a skateboarder ever won.
Right.
Yeah. That's awesome. Yeah.
I thought that. So after I rethought about it a little bit, it's hugely flattering. And, you know, and like the Vans family and the Van Doren family, like their hearts, the size of the world.
Sure.
They're beautiful people.
Yeah.
And so hugely flattered by it, you know, hugely flattered by it. It's at the front entrance of Vans, so that anyone who walks into the Vans brand building has to think about skateboarding right when they walk in.
When you drive out the Vans, do you have your own personal parking space?
No. I don't need that kind of treatment, man. I don't want to be first class.
He's got a statue in front, Raj.
Yeah, right, that's great. Dude, that's amazing. Yeah, statue in front.
That's insane.
I always felt like that. Like, truly, I always felt like I'm a skateboarder going to sit in first class. They don't want me here.
You know? Yeah, you feel awkward almost, like, right?
That guy's, you know, a dirtbag, and he's in first class. He must have just got a golden ticket from somewhere.
Yeah.
That's how I was meant to feel.
You got bumped up.
I always preferred to sit in the backs of the planes and fucking talk to people and just do shit.
Right.
You know? If I had a first class seat, you want it, take it.
Oh, I would have loved to travel with you.
You want to travel with me?
Yeah, I would love to.
I don't know if you get what I mean.
Absolutely.
I don't need that as a skater and as a pro skater. I don't need to have the balls fluffed and I don't need to make people to make me feel special, you know?
Exactly.
Not because it's not why I do it, you know? And but the statue was, like I said, after it settled in, I was hugely flattered by it. And, you know, and that's that. That's but I've never walked up to it. I've never touched it. I've never been closer than 20 feet to it. I've never really checked it out.
Does it make you feel weird in any way?
Like I said at first, yeah.
Yeah, you're like...
how would you feel?
Yeah,
I was right in front of you.
It'd be pretty trippy.
That would be really trippy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know what that would...
But if it came from somebody that you knew did it for all the right reasons.
Yeah.
Yeah, totally.
Right? You'd be stoked.
Totally.
Hell yeah.
Right? And that's how I feel about it.
Hey, you need to go check out the statue, man. Make sure they got everything right. You know, facial features, make sure they got
it
all.
Well, let's just put it this way. What year was that? 1999? I better look good.
Yes.
Did they take measurements of you before they made the statue?
Yeah. Well, actually, after they told me that they were making it, right? And they showed me what they were doing, there was some slight adjustments of... I was a lot fresher looking then than I'm seeing right here.
Do you know who the sculpture was? Like who sculpted it or who
the artist was? I don't know the name of the people, but apparently they're incredibly talented, incredibly well known for it. Like I said, I'm not that guy that cares about like things as much.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like I would have been just as stoked if somebody had walked up to me and gave me a big hug and thanked me for everything we've done as skateboarders at the brand.
Like, yeah,
that in itself would have been the same value for me. You know, I'm a people person. Things don't mean shit. They do to a certain extent, but when it comes to my friends and like relationships in skate or people I've skated with my whole life, I'm just fucking thankful we're still doing it.
Yeah, man.
And I'm also thankful that like a bigger brand that's in our industry cares enough, even though it has a business outside of skate, right? Like it's a huge lifestyle brand.
Mm-hmm.
It still does things that are very focused on
letting people
know how important skateboarding is.
Hell yeah.
You know, I'm thankful for that.
We're all thankful for that.
Yeah.